like money for getting the money. He just looked like all the zeros. Doesn't look good. Wow. Gotta give him a shout out.
Come here, Cedric. Let's straighten this up.
Yeah, I was, because he didn't button the top, it's too tight for him, so I was trying to get him right.
Oh, you got that big boy neck, huh? You done graduated to the big boy neck?
Yeah.
Which, yes, this one. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Mom was taking that lipstick. She need one. She's so funny. Oh my gosh, Kendris, this looks good.
Well, she done took off work.
This is, I am so grateful
She's
for
like,
you.
She's like, thank you.
You look beautiful.
You really do,
thank
Mom.
You.
So pretty.
Did it smile when I pan
No,
it?
Just the veil.
Yeah. Ooh, wee.
You tell me if you want it.
Further up.
Okay.
Let me
see. Let me hit the back. You want it further up?
So cute. Oh my God.
I would like to say to my groom that you have been the perfect fiance. You have been the perfect man that courted me. I've never been courted like that before. You have led me with love, with grace, and I am super excited about spending the rest of my life with you. I hope we have so much fun forever. I love you, Cedric Cobb. I cannot wait to see you at the altar.
Ooh, Kira Cherie, ma'am. Let me tell you what you're in store for. You have got a man that absolutely will not quit. It is never over until I win, which means now it's not over until we win. Baby, I love you. You bet on the right horse. And we're going to go out here and we're going to do some amazing things and let God use us in such a mighty way and get to live the best life we ever thought we'd ever get to live, because we're now went from being, through God's math, 1 + 1 = 1. So one whole you plus one whole me equals one whole us. I love you, baby.
It's not my own. I'm just you to hear my yes and leave me alone. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. My life is yours. I'll just say yes. Yes.
Yes, Lord. My faith, what means to
Not be looked upon lightly. As great as Adam was, it was still not good enough. The one thing that trumps individual greatness
is greatness in partnership. It trumps what we can do as individuals when God favors us with someone that has been constructed for covenant. We have an exquisite love here. We have a tested love here. Love must be tested. And there was distance between the both of you. And you encountered tests as a result of two families seeking to become one. You know, biblically speaking, sand speaks to abundance. God told Abraham that his descendants would not be numbered. Be so great, his descendants would be so great that there would be no tally, no way to count how many descendants would come from Abraham. So when we think of sand, we think of abundance. And we're praying right now that this marriage would be a marriage of abundance, that it would overflow with love, that it would overflow with peace, that it will overflow with joy. God has called for this union. And because God is in the midst and God has declared a blessing over them, we agree with that blessing and we declare abundance even now. Another thing that we can take from sand is the fact that glass is made as a result of sand being melted. What we're believing God for and what we're declaring right now, so as they're blending the sand and the sand is being poured, we're speaking intimacy, because it's not just two people coming together, but it's also a family coming together. And there's nothing like having a family to undergird your relationship, to undergird the covenant, to pray concerning the marriage, the union. Cedric and Kira, they have family that are coming together to experience this great moment with them. Isn't it amazing that God allows two lives to come together? And as a result of those two lives, each and every person that's attached to them get to share and experience the love that they both share with one another. It is the blending of two families. It is the coming together of two now being made one. Let us applaud this family. This is the favor of God. When God allows two to find purpose in each other, to see the purpose in each other, to understand that the union is about a God-ordained moment and season in life. The discovery of love is a discovery that we all want to experience.
There's not enough ink in a pen, words in a dictionary, or memory in a computer that can hold all the things I want to say to you in this moment. So here are the best words I have for you before God in the first chapter of us being husband and wife. I cherish you, my love. I am committed to getting my PhD in Kira Sheree University and graduate with honors. I promise to be your faithful spouse I vow to love you when the sun shines, when the rain falls, in sickness and in health, through good times and bad times. When you look at the ring that I'm about to place upon your finger, think of me and remember, I always love you.
My mother, before she passed away, told me that I was not supposed to stay single for the rest of my life. And I thought, God, how am I ever gonna know? And she said, the Spirit of the Lord would confirm it. And then came you, with not one, but two prophetic confirmations, one being from our very own pastor, that we are indeed husband and wife. It is clear that you, Cedric Cobb, and I are truly partners in love, in parenting, in business, in ministry, in friendships, in purpose, and now in covenant. So today, it is my absolute honor to vow to God and to you in front of our pastor, our parents, our children, our grandgirls, our families, and all of our friends the following things. Today, I promise to love you the way that you receive love, so that you will never live in a love deficit again. Today, I promise to seek God first concerning you, before I judge or disagree. Today, I promise to listen to you with the default of understanding and always respect. Today, I promise to follow you as you follow Christ. Today, I promise to help you in every area of your life as your most suitable mate. Today, I promise to let you spoil me without becoming a brat. I love you now, I love you live, and I love you later.
Wow. Do you both wish to seal the vows with the exchange of rings? I'll get ready to say, you better go find that ring.
Way too much, man.
Beautiful rings. Awesome. Cedric, placing the ring upon Kira's finger and holding it there, I be endowed. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Kira, repeat after me. I accept this ring as a token of the vow which you have made. Now, Kira, placing the ring upon Cedric's finger and holding it there, I want you to repeat after me. Cedric, with this ring, I thee wed. And with all my heart's affections, I thee and thou. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Cedric, repeat after me. I accept.
This ring.
As a token of the vow.
As a token of the vow.
Which you have made. Let's give them a hand. Because you have here in the sight of God and in the presence of this company made your vows to one another until death do you part, as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and according to the laws of the state of Missouri, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may not kiss your bride. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Cobb. What God has joined together, let no one or nothing separate. And we declare the favor of God upon them. And we declare no weapon that's formed against them shall prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, let's celebrate.
Got my back.
No backing out, right?
Mr. and Mrs. Cobb.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry. I don't know if you have. Do you see? Can you see the arch behind you? Can you look behind you real fast. Are you in the fourth? What's going on?
We're in the Four Seasons, yes. St. Louis, downtown St. Louis,
yes.
On our wedding day, yes. 12/12/22 at 2. That's right. We did. So we are officially.
Mr. and Mrs. Cobb.
That's right.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
Officially.
Yes.
They said put a ring on it.
Put a ring on it.
Those are rings
both.
On it, for sure.
Yes.
She did so good.
You did too, baby. Thank you.
Why is this so special, Cedric?
Well, I will tell you, first of all, the institution of marriage is a very, very special thing. Mm-hmm. God has already approved it and ordained it, but you got to give him an opportunity to put it together for you. So then that way the rules will work in your favor. Mm-hmm. If you come in and you try to do it on your own, it's just not gonna work.
Yeah.
It's like setting a time bomb in your relationship that's eventually gonna go off without God's help. You gotta get him in the middle of it and do your best to do it his way. So we know we have a relationship that is called for real true purpose. And our purpose is that we sit at the intersection of marketplace ministry and being advocates for singles who desire to be couples. So we're advocating for you singles,
yes.
And we want to help you,
yes.
Get through your single season,
yes.
And prepare yourself in order to be ready.
Whole,
oh God. Heal, whole, and free. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, yes,
yes, yes.
In order to get into a marriage. You know, we're in our 40s and we've been married before. And God gave us another shot at redemption.
Yes.
And so it really is a redemptive,
yes.
Love, and we've been able to build ourselves,
yes.
To be prepared for one another.
Mm-hmm.
And that has so much to do with it. It's, you know, it's not, marriage is not just about finding the right partner. It's also about being the right partner. So I always ask people, who do you be? Because based on who you be, it has a lot to do with who you can have.
That's right.
Right?
That's right.
And so we shouldn't have expectations of others that's not even close to the expectations that we'd be willing to live up to. So we are true champions for marriage.
Yes.
And we want to encourage each and every one of you, and we only know how or seek to do it God's way. That's
yeah.
it.
Because yeah.
that's who made the rules, and those are typically the marriages
yes.
that end up really, truly going and standing yeah. the test of time.
Yeah. So if you are out there, you are believing God for your purpose partner, do not give up. Do not,
yes.
do not lose hope. Do not feel like it's too late, you have too many kids, you're too old. That is not true. God has somebody just for you, and you can never fulfill everything that He wants you to do in the earth without your purpose partner.
Mm.
We are so much better now.
Yes, Lord.
Because we have each other.
Yes.
Get that.
Yes. Love you too.
When Kira started going back through her dating scenes again, I used to date Kira. I used to take her out on dates and show her what a man's supposed to be, how he treats her. And so Kira, she used to call me every Wednesday.
Oh God.
Every Wednesday she would call me. I bet you out of the whole year, she would probably miss maybe two or three Wednesdays calling me. And until she met Cobb.
Wow. Oh, my. Oh.
And then she missed a few. She missed a few. But I understood. But anyway, I told Kira when we were dating, I said, when a guy meet you, he's probably going to say, what are you looking for in a man? What are you looking for? I said, you don't tell him nothing. I said, you date him long enough and let him show you.
That's it. That's so good.
I said, just date, you know, and let him show you who he really is. And so Kira, you know, she wanted me to meet Cedric, you know, all this time she wanted me to meet. And she told me that Cedric played, that he's getting into golf. Golf is my passion.
Yes.
So we met in Savannah at my daughter's house. And I told Kira, I said, now I can tell you a lot about a man if I play a whole round of golf with him. I said, because it's a gentleman's sport. And I said, it's a lot about respect and courtesy and honesty. I said, you don't even have to ask. You can see it. And I said, so I can tell you after a round of golf if he's who he says. So the day that we went out and played golf, I'm looking up at this dude. I can't tell you what I said.
That's good though, it's good.
But during that round of golf, I already told Cedric that what I was going to do when we got back. And so when we got back, I had told him. But during the round of golf, Cedric had asked me
around about the 15th hole, he asked me for Kira's hand in marriage. So at the time, I didn't answer him.
You did not.
It was time for me to hit my golf ball, so I didn't answer him right away. So now he's sweating. So we get on around about the 17th hole, Cedric gets up, and he hits the golf ball, and he goes way over in the woods. But, you know, he's not concentrating now. No, I'm not. So he teed up another ball, and then went way over in the woods. So the rest of the round, that's the way he played golf. And so we went out to eat after that. Good. And so I carried Cedric back to his hotel, and Cedric said, so Ms. Hopkins said, you never answered me about could I marry your daughter? I said, no, I didn't. He said, but you didn't say no. So, but anyway, we got that straight. But anyway, I had told Cedric what I was going to do to Kira, so when I got back to Kira, she was all jolly and happy. So Dad, what do you think? And I said, well, baby. And she came in from shopping, she had all these bags, she dropped the bags, and she sit down. My daughter says, you want me to send the kids out? And she said, no. So she said, Dad, what do you think? I said, well, baby. She said, but Dad, I love you.
I take a lot, again, on three.
We've heard of each other.
Right, now go ahead and slow cut, make a small cut in there, make a beat.
Girl, it's a shame.
Nice, well, I've been foolish. Nice, breathing good. And now you got a car bumper, you feel like a difference. Try to get it out of there. Make a small cut for you guys. Don't make it too big.
I move with the letter of a pencil. It might roll